عبر حسابه الرسمي على تويتر أشاد الدبلوماسي الأمريكي السابق ألبرتو فرنانديز بأسلوب وزير الدولة السعودي للشؤون الخارجية عادل الجبير في الرد على الأسئلة العدوانية كما وصفها، حيث أعاد نشر مقطع من لقاء أجراه الجبير مع هيئة الإعلام الدنماركي في زيارته الأخيرة. وقال ألبرتو في تغريدته التي جاءت بالعربية: لقد كنت متحدثا رسميا ومسؤولا إعلاميا ودبلوماسيا في العديد من الظروف الصعبة، وعلي أن أقول كيف أحترم إجابات هذا الوزير السعودي على الأسئلة العدوانية. إنها مهارة مهمة سواء كنت تتفق معه أم لا. دعونا نتابع جزءا من المقطع الذي قصده ألبرتو فرنانديز في تغريدته.
My question then is shutting up the price of doing business with you? Do one Danish company run the risk of being locked down in Saudi Arabia if one politician in Denmark speaks up?
We are saying that there's a way to have conversations. And we have conversations with our allies in the West all the time about all issues, including women's rights, including human rights. We are not shy about explaining what we're trying to do because we're trying to reform our country and move it forward.
But this Canadian minister thought she was having a conversation with you.
But allow me to finish my point. We do not accept dictates. We do not accept people telling us what to do. We're not a banana republic. If you want to pick up the phone and call me and say, I have a problem with this issue, that is totally acceptable. But to go public and say, we demand the release, who are you to demand? We are a sovereign country that has its own laws, and we're not saying to Canada, we demand that Canada give independence to Quebec. So, what would the Canadians say if we said this?
So now I understand what insulted you, but then again, your reaction, not only did you expel the Canadian ambassador to Saudi Arabia, you also froze in or put on hold the business activities of Canadian businesses. And then my question is, then again, one person spoke up and the whole country paid a price. What's the logic here?
It's not one person. It's the foreign minister who represents the country. If the foreign minister cannot represent the country, then they shouldn't be foreign minister.